Yaskawa.
The Technical Training Department of Yaskawa America Incorporated presents Features and Benefits of Singular Control. Hi, I am Micah Studeman. In this video, I will give an overview of what singular control is, explain some of the programming components using an example, and explain the uses of the Penant Interface. So what is singular control? It started with an idea that all industrial devices could be controlled by one source. Yaskawa has done this by including the kinematic equations for these devices in the MPIC firmware. So you can have induction motors, servo motors, many different types of robotic mechanisms, all operated by a single MPIC controller. The easiest way to explain singular control is through an example. Here I have the singular control demo. The first station is made up of an HP20 6-axis articulated arm that takes the plastic squares from the sink conveyor holder and puts them on the feed conveyor. The second station uses a camera to detect the orientation of the plastic squares. The third consists of two MPP-3H Delta robots that take the scattered plastic squares and place them uniformly on another conveyor. The final station contains a sink belt with Sigma 5 servo motors that create separation between groups of 5 plastic squares and places them into a holder controlled by a SigmaTrack linear motor. Here is a simplified diagram of the singular control demo. Let's look at the control system of this machine. Commonly, in the motion control industry, the robots in this system would be programmed on a controller using their own programming software. The sink belt and the other conveyors would be programmed using a different motion controller and different software. Additional code must be created in each controller to talk between all of the controllers. This also means that multiple software projects need to be maintained for the machine. All said, you see that the traditional programming solution can be quite complex on a machine like this. Yaskawa's singular control platform simplifies this application by allowing the robot and the conveyors to be programmed using MotionWorks IEC and commanded by one MPIEC controller. This in turn reduces the number of projects needed for this system down to a single project. This is also beneficial when maintaining the machine because only one project needs to be modified, versus multiple projects in different manufacturer software platforms. I have created a project in MotionWorks IEC that simulates the functionality of the singular control demo and shows how simple it is to change out mechanisms in the project. For now, I will be focusing on the motion profile of the robotic arm, which will later be changed out for a more economical T-bot. This robotic arm moves an item from the lower conveyor and places it onto the upper conveyor. The move profile is very simple and is performed using the 6 function blocks shown here. Here is a graphical representation of what is happening as the positioning program runs. Looking at the robot arm, the 6 moves produce the motion of picking up, moving over, placing down, moving back up, back over, and back down for the next part. Since there is only one project to control everything, singular control allows robot mechanisms to be interchanged seamlessly in the code. This is very useful when prototyping or maintaining a machine because it means that you can easily swap out one mechanism with another mechanism. This same concept allows you to reuse code from a previous project with a new robotic mechanism. Let's look at this point in a little more detail. In the following example, I will switch the robot arm mechanism for the T-bot mechanism, and have the T-bot perform the same move as the robot arm. Notice that each of the 6 move blocks have an axis group input with a variable called robot arm. This axis group exists in the hardware configuration of MotionWorks IEC. In hardware configuration, I set up a T-bot axis group using 2 Sigma 7 servos. The same concept applies to any other supported mechanisms, such as gantry systems, and different types of H-bots and T-bots. At the bottom of the list, we have the custom Delta robots, along with the MPP-3H and MPP-3S Motoman Delta robots. Expect to see this list grow as more mechanisms are added in future firmware releases. Once the hardware configuration is saved, the required toolboxes are added to the programming window along with the robot arm axis group variable and the T-bot axis group variable. To switch to the T-bot, the axis group inputs to the six motion blocks just need to be changed to the T-bot axis group variable. As you can see, this is basically the only programming change needed to accommodate an entirely different mechanism. When changing out a mechanism, there are important considerations. One of these considerations is the orientation of the coordinate plane for the mechanism. A robot operates in the XYZ frame, and in this example, the base of the robot is mounted such that the motion path is in the XZ frame. The T-bot operates in the XZ frame. Since the coordinate systems match, this makes the mechanism swap relatively seamless. If the robot arm had been mounted differently, then additional programming would need to be used to convert the motion profile. Now let's talk about the robot teach pendant. Traditionally, each robot in a system has its own teach pendant. This is used as the main interface to the robot and will allow the user to manually jog the robot, teach movement points, and program the robot. These pendants are of different models and contain the specific programming for each robot. If you want to monitor or jog a robot, you need to learn and use that robot's specific pendant. With singular control, the pendant interface is connected to the MPIC controller, not the robot. This allows the pendant to interface with different robots without being directly connected to them. This way, the machine operator is only required to know how to operate one pendant. The pendant interface is used by adding a teach pendant driver for each of the robots in the MotionWorks IIC project. Singular control also allows any pendant that communicates via Modbus TCP to potentially be used as the singular control pendant, as long as the screens are created to communicate with the teach pendant driver. Yaskawa has pre-made screens that can be used if the Indesoft program is running on the pendant. This allows the user to find a pendant that fits the application and have it work with Yaskawa's hardware. The pendant interface can also be customized to act as an HMI that can be used to monitor and perform test moves of the entire machine. All programming is done in MotionWorks IIC, but the pendant interface is useful for teaching points to be used by MotionWorks IIC in the project. Singular control as a whole provides a centralized control source, simplified programming, flexibility to change out mechanisms with only minor project changes, and the means to reduce the time needed to set up a complex multi-mechanism system. Thank you for watching. To learn more about singular control, visit yaskawa.com.